A lot of powerful people know the psychology of colors, and they use it to manipulate you. I'm going to teach you how they do this in this video. Color psychology is also helpful for when going on a date, job interview, etc. because colors affect our behavior, our mood, impression on others. Even people working in the marketing industry use color psychology to manipulate the kind of emotions they want you to feel. So the first color is literally the most powerful color, and that's the color red. This color is my best friend, and I strongly believe it should be your best friend too, because this color makes women look so much sexier. Now, I'm not sure why, but when researching, a lot of sites claim that when women wear red, it makes them more attractive to men. But I'm going to tell you right now that this is not true. What it does do is it makes you stand out a lot more, which is what makes you attractive. A woman wearing red already shows she's not afraid to stand out. This shows confidence, and we all know that confidence is the number one most attractive thing on women. Now really think about this. Most of the images that represent passion and love are red. For example, red roses, red lipstick, red lingerie, red heart boxes or candy on Valentine's Day. This is even why we have red traffic light, because this color is very, very hard to miss. And apparently there's something about the color red that increases blood pressure. So ladies, wearing red on a date will definitely have him remembering you. Now look, the color red can trigger many different emotions like passion, love, sex, but also danger or power, which again makes it really sexy. And now the next color is black, and black really gives you this mystery, power, elegance, and sophistication vibe. Nice thing about this color is that it can give you this authority and power kind of vibe. And black just makes you appear a bit thinner. If you notice people are complimenting you, telling you you look like you lost weight, but you haven't done anything to lose weight, black is giving you, like, it basically gives the illusion as if you're a bit thinner than what you are. And also, ladies, if you're into those submissive kind of men, black clothes are really good with attracting those kind of men. Black and red will be your best color. Now, the cons of wearing black is that it gives off this independence vibe, independent girl vibe. It's also used to symbolize negative things. It's tied towards death and, you know, evil. And it can evoke feelings like anger, fear, sadness, depression. It's a stereotypical color as well for criminals. And the next color is blue. So many men like this color that it's hard to go wrong with it. Now, I don't know, a lot of people say that this gives off the vibe of conservative and traditional. I'm not 100% sure about that, but you can judge that on your own. And really, the blue color, like if you think about it, it just gives off this vibe of calmness and peace. There is something about the color blue that leaves the impression that you are loyal and trustworthy. This is why a lot of people say when you go to a job interview, wear the color blue. Because the interviewer will just unconsciously think that you are trustworthy. Think about it. A lot of countries have police officers in blue. And this is done on purpose so that you would trust them. I even spotted a lot of politicians wearing blue, and I promise you they know the psychology of colors, and it's done on purpose. And the next color is white. This gives off innocence and purity vibes. This is the exact reason why brides have white dresses on, and it's the reason why YouTubers, when they make an apology video, they wear white. If a YouTuber was to make an apology video wearing the color black, and then made the exact same video wearing the color white, I promise you, a lot of people will say when he wears white, the YouTube video seems more believable. When we think of angels, they wear white. White in general makes you look a lot more innocent. So if you need to apologize to someone, you know, if you want to look a little innocent and you've done something wrong, put on that color white. Now, if you're from the Western culture, the color white is associated with weddings, hospitals, angels. And in general, just gives a sense of purity, cleanness, and peacefulness. But on the other hand, if you're from the Eastern culture, white is actually a symbol of death and sadness. This color is used for funerals, mourning rituals. What's interesting to me is that every culture has been kind of manipulated to view colors a certain way. For example, white is a bright color. Designers often use this color to make rooms seem like they're larger and more spacious. But for other people, viewing rooms like that can give them more of like isolated vibes. or more like they feel like it's too empty, boring, or it gives off a poor vibe. And Russians are like the perfect example for this. So I have Russians in my family. I love, for me, less is more. I love like a house that's white, and just the less I have around, the better. And I just feel like it gives more of a rich vibe. But when my Russian family comes over, they're like, why is it so white? Why isn't there any like art on the wall or anything? Like, you have nothing here. It looks like you're poor. They literally have mats on their walls, and like, you just see decorations everywhere. Like, to leave a wall white to them is like as if you're poor. Like, they will literally color it in different colors, and that apparently for them in their eyes gives off rich vibes. So it's very interesting how people view this differently. The next color is bright yellow. Listen, yellow is such a powerful color, just like red, and it definitely grabs people's attention. This is the reason why we have traffic lights that are yellow, because it's impossible to miss it from far away. Listen, this color is so cute. Like, it's a happy color. It makes you look more youthful, healthy, energetic. And I promise you, if that man catches you in that yellow sundress on a summer day, he's definitely going to get that optimistic and cheerful vibe from you. It's a really, really nice color to wear. And this is really important because it can give you this massive, energetic, and super fun vibes. If we're going to be talking about darker tones of yellow, I would suggest avoiding them. Most women who wear these tones actually makes them look a lot less attractive. But again, there's exceptions to everything. In my opinion, the brighter the yellow, the better. But you need to make sure that you find the right tone for you. Now, of course, the color yellow also comes with its cons. Some people, like my friend, feel frustration and anger when they see this color. There's even research that babies tend to cry more in yellow rooms. So that's another thing to keep in mind. So our next color is gray, and gray is not very exciting. It's like it gives this lack of energy, quiet, and reserved type of person vibe. Too much gray can just create this like vibe of sadness and depression. Maybe a bit loneliness and isolation vibe, I don't know, but if this is not really the vibe you're trying to give, I would suggest adding more color, and it's going to change drastically the way the person will view you. This color is kind of, it gives the maturity, responsibility vibes. It's associated more to like old age, you know, gray hair that old people have. With this color, you're never going to be the center of attention and or the leader or the director. This color is too safe and so toned down that you may as well wear it when you want to be invisible. If you want to go and, you know, shop and you don't want dusty men approaching you, just wear gray and you're basically a ghost to them. And our last color is the color pink. Now, when somebody wants their target audience to be women, usually they would use the color pink. And honestly, the color pink is just so powerful because the effects that the color red gives and the effects that white gives, pink gives both of those effects together. So the color pink definitely gives off youth, playful, cheerful vibe. It's a very calming color. It's not threatening. And it just represents very positive aspects like traditional femininity. It can give off nurturing and kindness vibe, which is really nice, especially for a lot of women, because I know a lot of women like to have that kind of image. So if you want to have that kind of image, I would suggest going for a pale pink, because pale pinks are a lot more soothing. Darker pinks have a much more similar effect as red. And I guess, I don't know, the negative side effects are like, if you wear pink, it would probably, maybe it can make you seem somebody who's like weak, vulnerable, overly emotional, and inexperienced, which honestly doesn't even matter. Wear whatever it is that you look good in. And yeah, use the color of psychology to basically get whatever it is that you want in life. Anyways, that is it for today. If there's anything else that you want me to add on, fix, talk about, definitely let me know. And yeah, love you all.